Hi children, how are you? Now today we are going to see some more new article of our chapter Work, Energy and Power. In last module we have seen law of conservation of mechanical energy in freely falling body. Now today we are going to learn power. Always we talk about I have a power. So what is the meaning of power? I want to explain here. Suppose I assigned some work to three children of my class, say student A, student B and student C. Same kind of work I am assigning. Say a student performs work in 1 hour. Student B performs work in a half hour. And student C same kind of work only in 15 minute. So what we observe? हम किसे शाबाश कहेंगे? I can say the student C does work only in 15 minute. So I can say well done boy, well done girl. Same amount of work complete in small amount of time. I can say student C has a more power. Is it clear? Yes, sir. It is very simple. So here, my dear children, I am going to explain a term power, that is rate of doing work. Rate of doing work. Say if I am taking here in a 1000 liter tank to be filled by water by four different manners. Suppose first it completes by a manual labor or a weak labor. Secondly, it completes by a strong person or a strong person, say in a less time compared to a manual labor. Less time. Then thirdly, this water tank filled by a motor pump. Motor pump will take less time compared to this weak person or less person. Again. And fourthly, if I take a more powerful pump, four different types we are taking. What we saw in this case, when I have a more powerful pump, so it will take less time to complete or fill up the tank. So I can say, my dear children, what I can say, more powerful motor does more work in a unit time than the less powerful motor. Ye less powerful motor hai, ye more powerful motor hai. So thus, in many cases, when work is done, we are not interested only in total amount of work done, but my interest is that work is complete in how much time. So I have to say okay, what time you are taking to complete the work. So we have to use the term power. Which measures? So power measures, which measures the speed at which work is done. The speed at which work is done. The speed at which work is done, that is important. That will be counted as a power. That will be measured as a power. So power of an agent, what is the complete definition of it? I hope you have understand the term power. The power of an agent is defined as the rate of doing work, is defined as the rate of doing work. It is the rate of doing work. So power is in fact rate of transfer of energy. In fact, I can say it is the rate of transfer of energy. It is the rate of transfer of energy. Rate of transfer of energy. If an agent does a work W, say in a time T, if any agent complete its work W in a time T, the power is returned by P barabar W by T. So I can write the term power is W by T. But I know very well W is equal to force into displacement. But I know W is equal to F into S. So with the help of these two equations, what I can write? I can write P is equal to F into S divided by time. So I can say here F into S by T. Distance upon time. Distance upon time, we know very well, is V. So power is equal to F into V. This is the new formula. Force into velocity. So power is equal to work upon time, or you can write force into velocity. Here, write this formula. So power is equal to force into velocity. Power is also called activity. What is average power? What is the meaning of average power? Now, here I am going to explain average power. If an agent or any machine operates continuously, if a machine operates continuously, performing the same amount of work every second, the power it delivers may be called a constant. If machine is doing same amount of work in the same time, so I can say power is constant. But if it works irregularly, so the power fluctuates from moment to moment. In a different time, it completes different work. Different work, I can say the power fluctuates. In such a case, we talk the average power of the agent. The average power is equal to total work done divided by total time taken. Total time taken. The unit of power, it is the average power. What is the unit of power? It discovered by a scientist named James Watt. The unit of power is what? Unit of power is what? The power of an agent is said to be 1 watt. Power of an agent is said to be 1 watt. If it can work at the rate of 1 joule, it can work at the rate of 1 joule in 1 second. Time is equal to 1 second. I can write here 1 watt is equal to 1 joule divided by 1 second. the bigger unit of power is kilowatt. The bigger unit of power is kilowatt. Or 1 kilowatt is equal to 1000 watt. A unit which is exclusively used in engineering side. In engineering side, horsepower. 1 horsepower. That is 1 HP. जो motors मिलती है market में for pumping a water. It is of HP, half HP, 1 HP, 2 HP. So 1 HP is equal to, that is equal to 746 watt. This is a very important. Remember it. What is 1 HP here? That is 746 watt. So what is the difference in between power and energy, sir? What is the difference in between power and energy? Think first. What is the difference in between the power and energy? The energy of an object tells us the total amount of work. It tells about the total amount of work it can perform without any reference to the time. ये time की बात नहीं करता है. Without any reference about the time. But power on the other hand, it is the rate at which, it is the rate at which work is performed. Work is done. Or it is not talking about the, not talking about the total amount of work done. This is the difference in between energy and power. Is it clear? Yes, sir. Now, what is the commercial unit of energy? What is the commercial unit of energy? Commercial unit of energy. To express large quantity of energy. To express large quantity of energy, a joule is found to be a very small unit. A joule is found to be a very small unit, and as such it is inconvenient. So for this purpose I have to use kilowatt hour. KWH. Kilowatt hour. So 1 kilowatt hour. 1 kilowatt hour. Is the amount of energy. Is the amount of energy consumed. Amount of energy consumed means work done. Amount of energy consumed by an agent in 1 hour. By an agent in 1 hour. Working at a constant rate. Working at a constant rate. Working at a constant rate of 1 kilowatt. Of 1 kilowatt. This is the definition of 1 kilowatt hour. So what is the value of it? 1 kilowatt hour means 1 kilowatt kW आवर. तो 1 किलोवाट आवर इंटू 1 आवर, 1 किलोवाट मीन्स 1000 वाट इंटू 1 आवर, 1000 वाट मीन्स जूल पर सेकेंड इंटू इन आवर हाउ मेनी सेकेंड
सर 60 मिनट देन 60 into 60 दैट इज 3600
दैट इज सेकेंड. सेकेंड से सेकेंड कैंसिल हो जाएगा तो ये 36 1 2 3 4 5 जूल तो ये 3.6 इंटू 10^6 मेगा जूल. 1 मेगा इज इक्वल टू 10^6 जूल. तो आई कैन राइट हियर हियर इट इज 3.6 इंटू 10^6 जूल और 3.6 मेगा जूल हियर एम. तो 1 किलोवाट आवर इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड BOTU. What is this? Board of Trade Unit. Board of Trade Unit of our government unit. A unit in household industries and commercial establishment for measuring electrical energy consumption in our India. For example, if an electric heater 1 kilowatt hour, an electric heater 1 kilowatt hour, 1 kilowatt power is used for 2 hours, suppose. So it consumes 2 kilowatt hour or 2 units of electric energy or 2 units of electric energy. This is the meaning of it. 1 किलोवाट पावर का हीटर 2 घंटे तक अगर जलता है तो हमारे 2 यूनिट बिजली का बिल आएगा. इट इज क्लियर. तो दिस इज डियर चिल्ड्रन ऑल अबाउट टूडे. ओके बाय.